To SBR Forum videos. This is the Pete's Premium Parlay Show for the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. I'm Peter Loschak, and I'm going to give a parlay for the division round of the NFL playoffs. These are tough lines, though. I'm not feeling super confident about this parlay. Hopefully, it'll hit. If you want to, you know, tail, go ahead. But you know, I wouldn't necessarily recommend it heavily. But you know, I did look over the current lines and took all the information that I've gotten for various sources, and I put together a parlay that I think is the best that that I can do here. And there has actually been a bunch of these sides did actually take sharp action. I wound up, I'm going to go with two totals and two money lines. I'm going to use four legs, do a three and four team round robin, $20 base. All right, let's go over these games. I'll tell you who I picked. First game, New Orleans and Seattle. I am including the total in that one. And the side. I previewed that game with Duffy, Stephen O, and Jeff Cadillac. Stephen O, like Seattle, even at -8. And interestingly, Brent from BetDSI told me that that was also a sharp side. The sharps took Seattle at -7.5. So I'm going to take that one. I'm going to take Seattle on the money line, though, which is currently -390 at BetDSI. And that is a steep price to pay. But you know, I trust Stephen O. Stephen O's had a phenomenal record, you know, in our videos this year. And if his model likes Seattle here, for all the reasons that, you know, I'm sure we all know about, you know, Seattle should have a huge edge at home. I think they will be able to pull out the win. You know, if New Orleans wins the game outright, my parlay is busted. That's all right. But that's going to be one side that I'm going to use, endorsed by the sharp action, according to Brent and Stephen O. I'm going to take Seattle on the money line -390. That's a current line at BetDSI for that one. And then, if you watch the videos that we did this week previewing this game, I said I liked the under from the beginning, and I actually took it at 48 on the opening line. Right now, it's actually all the way down to 44.5 at BetDSI, and you know that's mostly because of the weather. But even before the weather reports came in, I sort of felt like the under might be a good bet anyway. And, you know, the lines moved down because of the weather, but I am going to include the under even at 44.5 as a second leg in the parlay, although I am going to take it 45 -120. You know, again, we've seen this happen many times this year where, you know, a game with bad weather, the total plummets, and the line winds up going over. If that happens, all right, the parlay is screwed. But, you know, I liked it a lot at 48. And considering the weather and that it is a playoff game, probably this will the weather will just encourage both teams to play conservatively. I'm going to include the under at 45 -120. Then Indianapolis, New England. I'm also going to include the money line in this one. I'm going to take the Pats. The Pats -335. Previewed the game with Duffy, Cadillac, and Higgs. Sean Higgs, newcomer. That's the guy who picked who recommended taking KC over the Chargers in Week 17. Awesome pick there. He says he loves New England -7. I can certainly see why. New England, you know, Brady and Belichick with a week off at home. I think they're going to find a way to get that win. -335, again, a steep price. These are tough lines, but that's going to be the third pick that I'm going to include in the parlay. It is interesting that Joe Duffy liked the under 53 in that one, and Brent also told me that he did take sharp action on the under at 52.5. So now it's all the way down to 51. But, you know, the weather should probably be not quite as bad as people are expecting. The winds are supposed to be, you know, picking up earlier in the day, but later on in the day, they're supposed to die down a little bit. So I wouldn't be surprised if that one wind up being a high scoring. But Duffy likes the under, and Brent told me that sharp action came in on the under as well. Then San Francisco, Carolina. This is going to be also a game I'm gonna include in the parlay. I'm going to take the total here, though. It's a tough one. I previewed this game with five cappers. Three of them liked San Francisco, two of them liked Carolina, and that fits squarely in with what Brent told me. Brent told me he got big, sharp action on both sides of that game. He has multiple groups, sharp groups on San Francisco and on Carolina. So, you know, to my eye, the side is a complete toss-up. The sharps are in disagreement. The market's in disagreement. I am going to take a shot, though, with the over at 41 -120. It's currently 41.5. At BetDSI, you can buy down to 41 -120. That's what I am going to do. I understand why this line's going down. Two super, super tough defenses, but I think that, you know, the weather should be very mild, and I think both Cam Newton and Kaepernick should have productive days. 41, that's getting down there. So I'm going to take the over 41 at -120 for the fourth pick in the parlay. And then San Diego, Denver, you know, that's an interesting game. I'm going to completely pass on that one. Both Troy West and Al McMorty gave the opinion that they like Denver. And, you know, it does seem that the Greek and Pinnacle also have leans towards Denver based on their lines. But and Joe Duffy made a very compelling argument for the under at 55. I could certainly see that. But I'm going to pass on that one. So those are my and on that game, though, Brent did tell me that that he took sharp action, though, on San Diego plus 9.5 and on the money line at plus 350. So that's, you know, it's an interesting line. I'm going to pass completely. So those are my four picks. Seattle under 45 minus 120. Seattle money line minus 390. Pats money line minus 335. And Carolina over 41 minus 120. And do $20 base round robin threes and fours. That's $100 to win 301.06. And if one of those totals loses, it'll still only lose about $40. So there you go. Very, very tough lines this week, but that's my Pete's Premium Parlay for the divisional round of the NFL playoffs.